Okay, I wanted to talk to you a little bit about a new website. I created my memorizingpharm.com or memorizingpharmacology.com website, and we've just revamped it. So I wanted to talk to you about why I did it this way, and then talk a little bit about what's here on the website for you. So first thing, the real problem that we have is that you're going to go into maybe a pharmacology class and you're going to use a textbook. And what we're seeing is these electronic resources that come with the textbook have a limited expiration date. So maybe you're taking pharmacology one semester, but the next semester you lose the resource, or the semester after that. And the issue is that you want to either keep practicing pharmacology or at least have pharmacology available before the licensing exam. And with pharmacy, it actually became even more of a problem, and I'll explain why that is. So those of you that aren't familiar with the PCOA, and I don't know if that's the right way to say the acronym, but the Pharmacy Curriculum Outcomes Assessment, one third of that includes the pharmaceutical sciences. So again, we have pharmacology and toxicology as part of that, and that's my specialty. And this happens, I believe, in the P3 year, so the third professional year, and it's a little bit goofy for some of those schools that aren't 4 years. So you have pharmacology class, and then you're going to be tested on your, knowledge of a number of things, mechanisms of action, adverse effects, and things like that. The next thing is that on the Nclex, 67% of that test has to do with pharmacotherapy and health outcomes. So twice you're going to be tested again on material that you had in pharmacology class. For the Nclex, it's a little bit different. Pharmacology and parenteral therapies, 12 to 18% of that test. But if a 120 credit nursing program only has one 3 credit pharmacology class, that means that there's a mismatch between the percentage of the curriculum that's dedicated to pharmacology and the percentage that's going to be on their NCLEX. And if you only take it one time, that's really hard to remember it. So my recommendation with something like that is to not only study pharmacology, but study physiology at the same time. But my goal of this video is to actually go through the website itself, talk to you about the resources that are available. So the heart of everything is the Memorizing Pharmacology book. It's an audiobook I created because I was just exhausted and with the triplets. And for those of you that don't know the story, when they came early, they couldn't suck, swallow, breathe. So my wife and I were feeding 90 minutes, going to sleep 90 minutes around the clock for 3 weeks. And I was like, how does someone get through pharmacology class if they're, having to deal with something like this? And so the book came out of that, a way to memorize pharmacology without with your eyes closed, really. Just a favor to me, if you do, if already bought the book or you're already reading it, about 15,000 people have bought the book. I don't really do the math, but if you can write a review on audible.com, that would be huge, or amazon.com. But the audible.com would be amazing if I could get to 300 or 400. I think we're at 120 now. That really makes a difference when it comes to their promotions and things like that. It'd make it so that more people could get it because it would be a little bit cheaper. Something you may not know is that Audible actually controls the price of the book, not me. So homepage, just some praise for it, some of the things from Amazon that people seem to like it pretty well. And that really, it's meant to be an audiobook. It's meant to be listened to. And that's kind of the whole thing with the graphic, that you're busy. Why not go for a run? Why not go for a walk instead of sitting down and trying to get through some 1.5 million word book? Other books that I've written that you may or may not know about, Goodnight Farm is 350 drugs. So it was top 200 memorizing pharmacology. If you want to get to 350, Goodnight Farm is what you want to go to. If you really struggle with the drug name pronunciation, I have a whole website dedicated to drug names that you can go to. And I also have a pre-pharmacy pre-med audiobook that explains the pre-pharmacy pre-med process. It's a couple bucks. And then the pre-professional interviewing audiobook that talks about the interview and some mistakes and pitfalls that some people make. And I've also translated that one to Spanish, so English or Spanish, either way. If you have the ebook, you know already that it's in Spanish and English in the ebook. Free classroom and study videos. So if you teach pharmacology, these are the free pharmacology resources that go with memorizing pharmacology, and I'll click on that here. So I'm not sure why that's not going away. The first one is the top 200 drugs, 7 video series. Some people are just very visual and they want to see the videos. And you can have 7 videos here. It's about 2 hours worth of content free that goes with the book that helps the students better see the content in the book. Okay, so we'll go back to the video resources. Q&A review and whiteboard videos. So it's by chapter, gastrointestinal, musculoskeletal, respiratory. Some are better built out than others. But for example, in respiratory, I have a bit of a, I'm working on a new book, which will be out hopefully in a couple months, that I go through 400 drugs and how to memorize 400 drugs. But not only the drugs, adverse effects, mechanism of action, some things like that that go along with it. Basically give you something to anchor your study for your licensing exam. That'll be coming out soon. And then I have these, which I call the quads, and I take 4 drugs and I change the questions instead of the answers so that you can kind of get a feel for some of those select all that apply type questions that are really tough. And by looking at these types of questions where you keep in your head, okay, well, these were the answers, what would make one of the other answers work, that challenges you in a different way. I encourage you to look at these. Some of the ones that are really built out are immune, for example. Multiple videos on the whiteboard, and then a number of these challenge questions, free questions as well, to support the book, kind of expand on the work in there. Okay. And then just a couple videos that have been really popular. This is Tyler Dalton from Auburn. He really did a great job of explaining the Nclex and some tips and what he did in terms of his study. And then the Nclex pharmacology. It's quite often that students will put off the second half of the Nclex book, and all Nclex books have pharmacology as the second half, and people are exhausted by the time they get there. So I have some recommendations on how to best study for that. Other things that are here, if you want a list of drug prefixes and suffixes, I have that here. If you want to take pharmacology with me, I teach it in spring and summer in a completely online course here at DMAC, so community college tuition, relative to what you might be paying at a four-year school. You won't believe how inexpensive it is. So it's about, I want to say $500 or $600 for a 4-credit class. Top 200. Every pharmacy college's top 200 is different. Some other schools use top 200. This is how you can take and make a top 200. I have about 1,200 videos out there. Some of them are just, this is the drug, this is what it's for, and you can put them together in a top 200. But I also have, and I'll go over those in a little bit, some extended pronunciation videos that can be really helpful. And then I just put some of the colleges that I know. University of Pacific put up their top 200 drugs. We have a great relationship with Drake, and I wanted to help those guys out. Had somebody from Cedarville email me and ask for their top 200, so I just put those up. And then over-the-counter is something that we don't really talk about much, but I have them in English and Spanish. Really just going about 50, 60 of those drugs. Those have got great images and things like that. So plenty of resources to help you with pharmacology. And then if you want to get in touch with me, if you have something you want me to, if you want me to do some kind of speaking or something like that, I can. I used to do it quite a bit, but I've since kind of tapered off with the kiddos. But you can also find my other resources at Tony Pharm D YouTube, where you have the 1,200 videos. Pretty extensive Twitter feed, so I've got, I think, like 6,000 followers or something there. And then Facebook is personal, but Facebook Messenger is really how people get to me most of the time. Of course, Pharmacy Future Leaders. I've got all the past episodes where I interview pharmacy practitioners and those people that are helping them. So from nursing, medicine, I've gone interprofessional there. Pharmacy Times, I'd written for quite a while there, and I need to get back into it. I kind of missed that, actually, and I'll start writing for them again. And then All Nurses, I have a number of videos there. And again, kind of going into that interprofessional deal. So let's go back to home. So again, I really, really appreciate it if you just click on like, let me know that you like the page, or please do give me feedback at any of those contact forms that I've given you. Again, hopefully this website will kind of put together some of those videos that I have out there and help you out a little bit. Now, I promised I'd talk to you about the extended pronunciation. So if you go to the How to Pronounce Drug Names website, it's howtopronouncedrugnames.com or HTPDN if you want. And then I have 350 or 400 drugs alphabetically in here. And these are different kind of videos. So let's use acetaminophen as an example.
Acetaminophen. Oops, with...
That's not a different kind of video. So the different kind of video might be easier to actually use YouTube. And I'll explain here. So if you go into YouTube and then my Tony PharmD channel, which obviously you're on because you're here. And then do this. And pick the drug that you want, so acetaminophen, for example. And what we do is, these back-building ones are a little bit different. This one got 22,000 views, holy moly. I go through the pronunciation extensively, okay? So if you put in back-building acetaminophen or how to pronounce, or whatever the drug is, back-building in the drug, it's as in comma, C as in ceiling, ta as in data, mi as in mint, na as in cannon, so it's not acetaminophen, it's nuffin, and then fen, like, is in hyphen. So these are really extensive, so if you struggle with pronunciation, so let me do another one, like omalizumab, probably did that. Okay, so you can find that one, how to pronounce omalizumab, and again, this is going to be a much more extensive one, where you can find extensive pronunciation, so using back building, and I'll figure out some way to put that in. So I don't want this video to go too long, but again, I appreciate it if you like the page, and then giving me feedback on Audible, Amazon, it's huge. If I can get to that kind of 300 to 500 on Audible, it really, really makes a difference. So again, I appreciate you watching the channel, and make sure to comment.